So that allowed me to get the first of the monitor eyes. Still have nothing up here. I'm not going to worry too much about it. Try and get through this as quick as possible. Here are these hits. Typically they die in 2 hits. Now anyway. It's good for me. Those shits have to respawn. Thankfully they're not within my range. How the hell did I get hit by slashing it? The game breaks its own rules. And now the platform will actually move. Well, might as well drop whatever the hell I'm doing and just go all the way back. I'm more than likely not going to be able to proceed any more than I already have without picking that stupid thing up. Whatever it may be. At least I got another level up out of it. At least this one's quick. Watch out and don't get spiked in the face. And I should have grabbed it right there. Transition or not. Oh dear god, not this one. Yep, we got block moving puzzles. Of course. Now let's see what we gotta do. Pretty sure that the big one is supposed to go off to the right. Ooh. That's the closest I've ever gotten to losing it. Although, still, it's not that big of a deal. And you can't push it if it's too close to the edge, which is bullshit. So, let's just push this down one. That way we still have room. And then we push this short one over a little bit. So I'll go get healed again. And there's no way to extend the gauge or anything. There's no upgrade for it. So what you see is what you're stuck with. Now we take our big block. Push that up. We push this all the way down because we're basically done with it. I don't get healed again. Christ's sake. Could have made it a bit longer. But no. Gotta be a big blast penis. There. Now we should be able to get through to the next area. Bingo. Super simple. But now there's another one. Although this one is a bit easier to comprehend. Push this one up. Then push any one of these off to the sides. It really doesn't matter. Let's get healed again. And we'll push the closest one to the one on the right. Off you go. Open the door to the exit. Bravissimo, let's get the fuck out of here. Should be pretty easy, just run right through everything. Not a bad puzzle. They kind of They kind of screw with your head by giving you two blocks, one bigger, one smaller. You have to decide which one you actually need. But if you put the big one on the left, you're not going to be able to reach the thing. You're not going to be able to reach the ledge. So that's your solution. All right, get through this garbage. Now we can actually move on without worrying about anything. This nonsense. There's evil and then there are boxes. Bypass these guys. I'll kill them off anyway. Free XP and all that. It's never off in the real world. And this is where you actually do have to do a little bit of platforming in the real world. Not many other places actually do this. Not revisiting the places. Just basically the sewer and the second to last area of the game, I mean. Where he learned that his leap is not all that good that it is in the Shadow Realm. Morris is a locked door. Saw blades, thankfully, are easy enough to avoid. Seems like fitting saw blades pretty much everywhere. Like right here, for example. And force type. No surprise. On the right, it's easier target. Take care of that and go and stab the giant right in the shins until it dies. Simple, simple, simple. No, I actually have to find a way to get to the last monitor eye. Thankfully, they're switching one of these, so problem solved. And that's where you first see that it's actually golden in color. Thankfully, not that long of a drop, so even if you decide to go without the pillar, it won't do any damage. And voila, the first of the basement levels is done. It's only gonna get harder from here. We literally went from the top to the bottom in terms of levels. Oh, everything's starting to look nice and bright and pretty and looks like we're almost done. Nope, you get dragged the fuck back down. Into the grime, into the gook. Into mediocrity. Off to the second floor, then. Let's get through this, and then the third floor is right around the corner. Well, there's one right off the bat, but, of course, only the light version can touch it. It's also a very good way to distinguish which version can actually grab the damn thing. Wait for it, you dumbass. Now you run. Because I don't want to go down there. Well, that's gonna help out a bit later. The light form anyway. Here's the other one. At least we know where they all are. Not that helps all that much. Boy, so passive-aggressive. Okay. That one leads to nothing, obviously. So does that one. So we'll pick this one. Alright, we gotta get that gate open. Can't do it through those means, so we'll have to look around. And there's nothing over here that we can get, so get back up there. All this to get, basically just get to a door. We have found the most complex and intrusive and annoying ways to get to a door. Opens up that pathway. Now lead us to another solution that we need to do in order to open up the gate that we're already in. Thankfully, you don't have to open up 20,000 other gates just to get to one area. Basically, it's like three switches. May seem daunting and all that, but really it's just busy work. Go from here, now go to this realm. Now go around till you hit a switch, then go back. It's all very runaround-ish. Your concept can only take you so far. That's to where we were before. At least I won't have to switch back to the shadow world just yet. Take a small breather. And then fall down into the guppy hole that is this area. Quickly hit the switch. And there's your exit. Not too bad, but constant switching can kind of get on your nerves. Alright, what's next? Take care of this. And right back to the light realm, of course. Let's see what we can do here then. Be prepared to be very much. We'll explore and see what we can figure out. Yeah, this place is huge. Only something hiding right off the end. Of course, it's just a damn memory. The shadows have faded away. This is why there's so many memories among the power. So, is it just one kid? Or is it actually other people? But if that's the case, then wouldn't the boy already know all these? Or is it slightly different versions of them when they get cut off? Big, big ladder. And yes, that part's going to be locked off from me, considering I haven't really done a damn thing in order to open it. Nope, there's nothing over here. There's Jack. Crap. But it opens up the first one. Brand. I think all of them are golden in this, so you're gonna have to use the light form for these. Kind of would have liked it if they gave you the option to get one version of the mod or eye over another. Kind of influencing how the ending would be revealed. Like, would you stay a shadow, or would you go back to being in your light form the more you use the light form? But nope. no such thing in this. Whatever. Saves me the trip. Okay, so I should be able to get this one now. Worked hard enough for the damn thing. The cage just slams you down. That'd be a big dick move. But it's only the second of the three. Meaning I probably missed something. Of course, everything has to get reset, because they went through the freaking shadow corridor. Probably what I missed. See what trouble we can get into in this area. Of course that has to fucking reset too! Damn it. Go back and just activate it all over again. I barely even see the stupid thing. Get down, you stupid. Not even a child anymore, you're just a stupid. And also, why is the kid wearing a hoodie? They just had to shove those into basically every kind of media now. This one is somewhat easy to get to. Now we'll just leave the third. They have to design it like this on purpose. Just to beat dicks. Oh, you might not make it in time, so there you go. Also, you can't get over the blades without those safeguards being up. Just fall and die. With that taken care of, we can hopefully get to the end of this place. No more resets. Of course, it's a forced fight. Of course! Yeah, that was difficult. But it's not over. You get a second wave. All you really gotta do is just dash to one side and they'll see you and get spooked. Then two slashes and they're done. Jump those. Just missed me. Do it when it's just fallen down. Don't slap me, you dick. I'll slice yours off. Nothing activated, so we gotta activate something ourselves. Oh god, it's the hoppers. No time to deal with your stupid shit. And that should activate it, right? Nope. Stops the blades from moving. That lot of good that does. Activated over here, I'm guessing. Yeah, there's nothing you can do over here. There's not even that hidden pillar or anything. One little hit ain't gonna do that much to me. So don't feel too proud. Yeah, of course activates as soon as I get on the damn thing. Thankfully, it's not a complete prick, and it doesn't drop you in. Just gotta lead them into the spikes, and that's it. They are that stupid. And I'm guessing more down action is required. Be a bitch climbing all the way back up, but that's to be expected. Barely scraped by that one. And of course, now the ladders will fall down. Proper pacing is needed. And it's pointless because I can't even get into that room, so I'm gonna go back here. All the way back up. Even though the last few ones had me going back up on a pillar. Can't let the game do whatever it wants to do. There has to be some kind of fucking rules. And I see that pillar there that you're trying to sneak by me. Right by. Now the room is open. I'm guessing what I activated was actually the exit. Wait, my luck. Would say kill yourself, but it seems you already did that. Now you head back down again. Just do it right in the fucking face, please. Give me a reason. I don't think that this recovers health. Nope, just the life. Thankfully, now all of them are taken care of. I don't have to do this again. Ever. Unless I feel like torturing myself. The only reason why you would want to go to the 5th and 4th floors, unless that's the area that you went first, is just to get the other memories. It can't be all that worth it. Let's see where this leads. Or we head off to the 3rd floor. Get through that one. Slice him away. And another force fight. They really gotta stop dropping those on me. It's starting to get annoying. Speaking of drop. Little shits. Yeah, that is the exit. And what the hell's the point of the other thing? It's probably just another fucking memory. I'll sate my own curiosity. Since the ladder's already down, it's not going to become that big of an issue. I see I'm not going to activate that again, unless I call myself an idiot. Who's guessing it's just gonna be a damn memory? Any takers? Guy in the back, put your hand down. You know better. I'm guessing anyway. Of course, for something so optional, they gotta stick a saw blade right in your face for it. barely make it over that. Let's see. At least the drop down is going to be smooth. Hitting my head on the way down. I knew it! It had to be a fucking memory. That was definitely worth it. Christ's sake. All that for when I can't even fucking read? Fuck you, game. Fuck you and your non-existent mythos. Let's just get down to the third floor and call it a night. Like I said, at least the drop was nice. It's gonna be an even bigger bitch because I'm gonna have to cut all the way through this, but... Well, for you guys, it's gonna be a cut. For me, I'm actually gonna have to work all the way back to the damn elevator. That's gonna be a bitch. With that, we finally unlock basement floor 3. Of course, getting the stained glass out of here is going to be no easy task. Let's just start off with tarantulas. You dicks. I think there's another memory over here. I think I'll pick that up and then I'll end things off for the day. You're on it, stupid. This one's simple enough to get. Won't have to pull my hair out or anything. All these scattered memories are mine. All of us are born from the same body. So the game finally confirms my suspicions. They're all the same kid. How does that make sense? Why just now does he finally understand it? It's gonna drive me fucking crazy. I'm gonna stand up here to avoid any monsters, and I'm gonna call it a day. As we're gonna have a big, big pathway ahead, and a lot of fast forwarding is gonna be required. So next time in Let's Play Lost in Shadow, we'll get through floor 3 of the basement, grab the stained glass, and then we'll fast forward through the rest of the stained glass acquirings to see what comes next in the story. I'll see you guys for the next one. Peace!